Assalamu alaikum. I am your host Muhammad Munib Ali. Today the topic of discussion regarding horticulture is conocarpus. What is conocarpus? Conocarpus is a tropical tree which is grown in hot environment. The tree beneath which I am standing, this is called conocarpus. Its botanical name is Conocarpus lancifolius and Conocarpus erectus. Its Arabic and Urdu name is damas. It has many benefits, many drawbacks too. Let's discuss the benefits and drawbacks, then we will conclude either we should grow this tree or not. Let's move towards next segment. This tree Conocarpus, it has many benefits, such as it is a very cheap tree, cheap plant, no need of extra finance, it can be grown easily. It is fast growing tree, it can be grown in saline water, it can be grown high TDS water, it can be grown in abundant water, it can be grown in drought condition. All of these it can be grown, it is a survival condition. It can be grown for hedge making, wall making, privacy making. It can be used for as wind breaks. It is amongst those some of the trees which can cover all the stem with the leaves. So this is a good property of this. It can be grown for avoiding sand erosion, soil erosion, hill erosion. So on both sides of motorways, highways, roads, it can be grown, and after rains and heavy storms, the roads, there wouldn't be any erosion. We will see. These are the benefits if we will consider. So this is a good tree, but there are drawbacks too. Some of the drawbacks, like its extensive root system. This plant is grown there, and if there is not a water available, water is available, suppose after 1 kilometer, you can't imagine that roots will travel towards water even after a 1 kilometer. Roots will grow inside the building structure, swimming pool, ponds. It will grow wider, it will rupture the structure. In past one decade, there are many noted complaints of that ponds and swimming pools have been punctured by the roots of Conocarpus. So this is a devastating drawback of this tree. In this way, we will conclude we should not grow this tree. Second drawback, this plant, this tree, it produces seeds. The seeds mean spores. When these spores spread into the air, these create pollen allergy, dust allergy, lungs allergy, inhalation problem. So in this is also a devastating drawback. We should not grow this tree in community area. Third of all, it can't be grown by biodiversity. For biodiversity, it can't be grown, because birds and animals don't attract towards it. Birds don't make nests on it, birds don't feed on it. So this is a tree which is totally against the fauna of any city, any area. In this way, we will conclude we should not grow this tree. And if we will grow this tree in bulk quantity and there are reservoirs of water beneath, it sucks all the water within years and creates drought condition. And the leaves of this tree, these have capability to absorb all the moisture around, which don't allow the clouds making. So in past 1 and 2 decades, scientists have suggested don't grow this tree in bulk quantity, because there is a prominent decline in rainfall has been observed. So these drawbacks are of Conocarpus, in which we conclude that we shouldn't grow this tree. So we have a discussion about benefits of Conocarpus and drawbacks of Conocarpus. There are more benefits than drawbacks, but these less drawbacks have more bad impact over benefits. In this way, the total result is that we should not grow this tree, because this tree is totally against the ecosystem. We should not grow this tree near community area. We should not grow this tree near fauna of any city. We should not grow this tree near water bodies, water features, lakes, ponds, building structure and utilities like sewerage and drainage. Next, I'll come with a new topic regarding horticulture. Till then, stay safe, keep watching. Assalamu alaikum.